Hello, I am Bishop Earl Boyea of the Diocese of Lansing. I invite you to join me for some brief reflections on seven meals in people's homes where Jesus gives us some very good table talk. Jesus' action at the outdoor picnic when he fed 5,000, I repeated now at a much more intimate dinner, his last with his apostles. He took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it. What really made this Paschal meal unique were his words, "With a desire, I have desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer." This was something Jesus really yearned to complete before his Good Friday. Certainly, Jesus changed the whole nature of this meal by himself becoming the Passover lamb in the gift of his body and blood, and in the command to celebrate this sacrificial meal in memory of him. But the Lord had something additional in mind as he ate this Last Supper with his friends. Twice in this brief account before the institution of the Eucharist, Jesus mentions the kingdom of God. First, he notes that he shall not eat until there is fulfillment in the kingdom of God. Then, after taking an early cup of wine, just before the heart of the meal began, he said he would drink no more wine until the kingdom of God comes. The first sense of these phrases is that he was telling his followers of his impending death. This really was now the end of their time together. But it was even more than that, for it was also a signal of the future, that there would be another meal, a greater banquet. Scholars are split on whether this is a reference to the meals Jesus would share with them after the resurrection, or the heavenly banquet to which he was calling them at the end of time. I don't know why it can't be both. At this meal, Jesus was giving his all to his closest friends, and he wanted them to know that he would be with them soon and forever. Thus, he would again eat and drink with them, as we hear in the last chapter of St. Luke's Gospel, at another picnic. While they were still incredulous with joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of baked fish. He took it and ate it in front of them. Jesus also gave his band a foretaste of the heavenly, messianic banquet. No longer would they celebrate the liberation of the people from slavery in Egypt. Now the liberation would be from sin and death, when the kingdom would fully come, that is, when Jesus would come again. My sisters and brothers, the lasting memorial meal, unlike the other dinners we have been discussing, was at Jesus' invitation. As Athanasius has written, we eat of the word of the Father, the Son, our Savior. We have the lintels of our hearts sealed with the blood of the new covenant. The heavenly banquet, the communion which we shall enjoy with the Savior in eternity, is already ours, since the kingdom has come even as it awaits its fulfillment. This is one dinner party we are happy to do in remembrance of him.